Yeah. Those sentinels must be stopped. We cannot tolerate this any longer. The barbarism they displayed yesterday was only the latest in a long line of offenses. But we all know there will be many more and greater crimes to come. Surely, Mornstead has suffered long enough in their shadow.
The fate of Mornstead and every single soul within it is mine to decide. Fate in my hands. You would do well to remember that, Fitzroy.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Thank you. Our holy work continues, Lamp-bearer.
Fellow sanctified vessel, may Aureus' divine radiance flow through me and into you.
Justin, I'm sorry. This was all my fault. I just wanted things to be better for us. And forgive me. No, get that away from...
I look upon you with pity, my lost child. For you have been deceived and enslaved by forces who regard you as nothing more than an instrument through which they might enact their blasphemous will and prevent my rightful return. They speak of light while offering you nothing but blindness. Weak hypocrites relying on the malignant power of Umbral. With one breath, then decrying it with another. They brand me evil, a tyrant, and yet I offer you something they will not. A choice. Reject the fanatical crusaders and the deranged servants of the self-proclaimed judge. Dismiss all of their false dogma and the torturous mission to which they have bound you. And only then will you know freedom. And if you would hear it, the truth.
Meanwhile, mankind set about ruling themselves,
free from the divine oppression of which they accused me. And yet, how little time passed before the judges themselves were raised to the status of demigods. Because of worship, their real ambition all too clear. Yet an outcome. The people deluded themselves into believing a triumph. How much blood has been spilled in their names since my banishment? Far more than was ever spilled in my dissident hubris of humanity.
Chosen bearer of the lamp until her embrace.
To open your eyes to their manipulations, to millennia of shameful distortions of the truth. For eons, I stood as mankind's guardian, shepherding them with wisdom and love. Yet in return, I was betrayed. Those three power-hungry malefactors who declared themselves judges turned my own children against me and waged a terrible war of needless slaughter. The judges and their crazed followers butchered those who remained loyal to me. And when I created the Rogar as a means to put an end to the madness, they too were no match for the heathen forces. In the end, even I fell. The judges found themselves unable to kill a god, despite their best efforts. In a world left blackened and corpse-choked by their crusade, the judges banished me to this barren realm, which has served as my prison ever since. Meanwhile, mankind set about ruling themselves, free from the divine oppression of which they accused me. And yet, how How little time passed before the judges themselves were raised to the status of demigods. Figures of worship, their real ambition all too clear. Yet an outcome. The people deluded themselves into believing a triumph. How much blood has been spilled in their names since my banishment? Far more than was ever spilled in my name. And now, after all the time mankind have had to shape their own destiny, see what they have made of it. War, greed, hatred, suffering, chaos. They believed they were capable of guiding themselves, but have been proven sorely mistaken. Mankind needs me now more than ever. Of other beings who claim godhood. Where are they? What of Aureus and the abhorrent umbral creature? They are cowards, hiding in force light and obfuscating shadow, deeming you unworthy of their presence, their communion. And yet, here I stand before you with true words and open arms. For I love all of my children, even the wayward ones. Listen to me. You must stop this before you allow yourself to condemn all of mankind for eternity. I am not your enemy, only what my own enemies fear. The loss of the dominion they have established for themselves in my absence. Cease your misguided violence. Now! You are in the presence of a god-human. Your god! I formed you from nothing and can just as easily destroy you. Yet you would dare defy my will. The world in which you exist is my world, my home, and yet mankind, my own creation, exiled me from it. You have no idea what it is to suffer such a monstrous betrayal, or to endure the ages of torment which followed. Consistent hubris of humanity. created the Rokar as a means to present to the madness. They too were no match for the heathen forces. In the end, even I fell. Although the judges found themselves unable to kill a god, despite their best efforts. In a world left blackened and corpse-choked by their crusade, the judges banished me to this barren realm, which has served as my prison ever since. Meanwhile, mankind set about ruling themselves, free from the divine oppression of which they accused me. And yet, how little time passed before the judges themselves were raised to the status of demigods. Figures of worship, their real ambition all too clear. Yet an outcome, the people deluded themselves into believing a triumph. How much blood has been spilled in their names since my banishment? Far more than was ever spilled in my name. And now, after all the time mankind have had to shape their own destiny, see what they have made of it. War, greed, hatred, suffering, chaos. They believed they were capable of guiding themselves, but have been proven sorely mistaken. Mankind needs me now more than ever. And what of other beings who claim godhood? Where are they? What of Aureus and the abhorrent umbral creature? They are cowards, hiding in force light and obfuscating shadow, deeming you unworthy of their presence, their communion. And yet, here I stand before you with true words and open arms. For I love all of my children, even wayward ones. Listen to me. You must stop this before you allow yourself to condemn all of mankind for eternity. I am not your enemy, only what my own enemies fear. The loss of the dominion they have established for themselves in my absence. Cease your misguided violence. Now. Of a god-human. Your god. I formed you from nothing and can just as easily destroy you. Yet you would dare defy my will. The world in which you exist is my world, my home, and yet mankind, my own creation, exiled me from it. No idea what it is to suffer such a monstrous betrayal, or to endure the ages of torment which follow. Will and prevent my rightful return. Yeah.